I'm very excited about today's vlog. It's a topic that I'm super passionate about and honestly something that used to be a really big insecurity of mine. So today's vlog is going to be around cellulite and my tips on how I reduced my cellulite. Before I start, I obviously have to make a disclaimer because hashtag YouTube. I'm not saying that cellulite is bad or you should be ashamed if you have cellulite. It's super, super common and I still have cellulite to this day. But I do read your comments and I like to make content that you guys want to see. And a lot of you guys have asked how I reduced my cellulite. Ages ago, I posted a picture on my Instagram of my before and after. My cellulite used to be pretty intense. Like I had it almost everywhere. And then I completely revamped my life and I saw huge improvements. Still have a little bit on the back of my legs and like under my glutes, but nothing compared to what it used to be. I thought I would take you through a couple of days of my life and just show you the little tips and tricks that I do to reduce my cellulite. So the first workout I'm going to talk about is super simple, super flexible. You don't need a gym membership, so you don't have an excuse. And it's walking and running. So when I started incorporating more running and walking into my lifestyle, I noticed a huge improvement in my cellulite. I don't want this to be a weight loss video, but at the end of the day, scientifically and factually speaking, if you do lose weight and do lose some body fat percentage, then majority of the time, the appearance of your cellulite will reduce. But also, moving my body in an aerobic way does wonders for my entire body. And especially when I'm running, I try to use my arms, I try to use my whole body, engage my core. So it's pretty much a full body workout. And I honestly feel like everyone's body and body composition is different, so you thrive off a different kind of workout. When I run, my legs completely change. So while I'm at a point in my life where I'm really happy and content in my body and I do feel confident, I would say that my problem and struggle areas are my arms and my legs. Since becoming healthy and fit, I can get abs quite easily and I have a pretty lean stomach, but my arms and my legs are the things that hold on to fat, they show cellulite. I'm going to go for my 5K look. I think I'm gonna run 2.5K and then walk 2.5K back. So that is the first tip of the day. If you are stuck for workouts and you think you have to do all these crazy leg routines, I am going to get into them, but you don't have to. You can simply just go for a walk, move your body, make sure your blood is pumping and circulation. And studies have shown that increased circulation within the body will reduce the look of cellulite. Where are my earphones? If we live different lives, my dreams, my arms, my eyes will always miss. Cute. Don't be alarmed, sisters. Majority of this is not because I worked hard. It's pretty much because it's like 40 degrees Celsius outside. But I ended up running the 5K, not in like a personal best time. I think I'm just gonna go like dive in the ocean just to cool off. Before I go in the ocean, I need to talk about the second tip of reducing cellulite. Drum roll! Water. I know we hear this all the time and it's like mind-numbing by now, but water is your bestie, your BFFL. Oh my gosh, this is actually about to like slip out of my hands because I'm so sweaty. I'm sorry if this is really off-putting. I just want to get this tip out of the way before I go in the ocean. My eyes are burning because there's sweat in my eyeballs. Oh my gosh, I actually can't see. Water, it's really good at detoxing the body, flushing everything out, and getting all the bad buggies out of your system. Our apartment doesn't have the filtered water tap, so I went and bought this jug from my health food store, and it's like a natural water filter kind of thing. So I will easily go through two of these jugs every single day. If you don't like water, I would suggest putting something like lime or lemon into it. And thinking back to it now, I actually noticed a huge improvement in my stomach. I don't know if any of you guys are going through this, but I had really bad cellulite on my stomach. So I had it on my stomach, my arms, the back of my arms, front of my legs, that was pretty intense, and obviously the back of my legs and my booty, which is where most girls hold their cellulite. So I'm gonna go and jump in the ocean, and next time you see me, I'll be a little less disgusting. All right, it's the next day and I'm looking for my earphones, but I don't know where they are. And I'm about to head off to the gym and show you guys some exercises that I found really reduced my cellulite. For me, it was all about my hamstrings and my booty because that is where my cellulite was really obvious. Where are my earphones? I got no idea where they are. So there's a few different exercise styles and workouts that I want to show you in particular. I'm going to go to the gym and show you a bunch of them, really using resistance to help grow your booty and grow your hamstrings. I found that it didn't make me grow in like a bulky way. It just sort of made my legs more toned and lean, and I noticed a huge reduction in cellulite. I will do some non-weighted exercises, so if you don't go to a gym, you can do some things at home. Really don't want this vlog to be about cellulite being the enemy and you should be ashamed, because I have cellulite and my cellulite used to be the reason I didn't wear shorts. One day I truly adopted my saying, hashtag act confident and no one will question you, and that's what I do now. Now, but one thing that I forgot to mention was also like plyometrics and aerobic style workouts. Like I said, you want to increase your circulation and the blood flow throughout the body. So things like jump squats and jump lunges. So they are the workouts, but I think we are going to go on to food. It's all about hydration and getting the toxins out of your body, but also you can implement certain ingredients that are going to boost the collagen, the circulation, the antioxidants, and the mineral content within your body. So I'm going to go through a few of my favorite ingredients, whole foods, and supplements that I use to decrease my cellulite. Enjoy!
One of the main things you want to include into your diet is antioxidant rich foods. So think berries, acai berry, camu powder, and anything that's a deep purple or red color. So antioxidants help to cleanse the body and reduce free radical damage. And ultimately, free radicals can cause circulation destruction. Think berries, pineapples, papayas, matcha green tea, and acai berry powder. The next thing you want to focus on is vitamin A and iodine, seaweed, spirulina, and baby spinach. And my personal rule is the deeper green, the better. So think deep green spinach, kale. So I ended up buying these little seaweed sprinkles, and you can put it on top of your salad. Or if you don't want to do that, I would put a tiny bit of spirulina in a green smoothie. Next up is healthy fats. So you really want to be getting a good quality omega-3 into your diet. So think walnuts, flaxseed, flaxseed oil, hemp seeds. If you can stomach it, I highly recommend cod liver oil. Another thing that you want to consider is your overall gut health and also boosting the collagen throughout your body. So my favorite forms of this is bone broth. Full of amino acids, boosting your collagen production and just helping smooth out the texture of your skin. And then finally, again on the same wavelength of water, it's all about hydration. hydration. So utilizing foods that have a high water content, cucumber, watermelon. In my smoothies, I will use a teaspoon of coconut water powder. Sometimes you just don't feel like water, so I usually have a kombucha every single day. Not only is this great for your gut health, but it is going to help hydrate your body. But honestly, at the end of the day, you don't have to overcomplicate it. Just focus on real foods, whole foods, and hydration, and you will notice a huge improvement.
I feel like people are gonna spy on me.
We have reached the final point of this video. My last stage, my last little tip of how I reduced my cellulite. Back in the day when I was trying to get rid of my cellulite, I would do this religiously, almost every single night, but definitely 3 times a week. I admit I've been really, really slack with it lately. Again, it's all about circulation and also really focused on penetrating and engaging that fascia. So I just use this little contraption. This one's by EcoTools, but you can get ones with a big stick. I used to have one like that, but I actually prefer these ones now. Do you know what it reminds me of? A horse brush. I make sure I do my entire body and I do it before I hop into the shower, and it's dry, so you don't need any water, you don't need any liquids or lotions. So the way that I do it is the direction is always towards my heart. It's about circulation, getting the blood pumping to your heart and increasing oxygen throughout the body. Nice long strokes up your arm and the same as your stomach, upwards motions up your stomach towards your heart. Don't push so hard that you're going to like have scratches up you, but you definitely want to feel like a tingling sensation. I'll do like an upwards motion on my calf like this, and then when I get to the back of my thighs and my booty, I press quite hard and I do a circular motion. I really try to increase the circulation and the blood flow throughout that part of my body. Try to do that for around 5 to 10 minutes. Dry brush, hop in the shower, and make sure you apply a nice moisturizer afterwards. That is going to conclude this video. They are my top tips on how I reduced my cellulite. There are obviously loads of different things that you can do, but this is just my story and how I did it. Cellulite is nothing to be ashamed of. Majority of us have it. Sometimes it just comes down to genetics, and it doesn't mean you're unhealthy. It doesn't mean you're overweight. Sometimes it's just the luck of the draw. Like for instance, I have cellulite and my older sister doesn't and really never has. Genetics do definitely play a role in it. But I honestly hope this video helps you in some way. Even if you're not trying to get rid of cellulite, you can implement any of these strategies and tips just to increase the overall well-being and healthiness of your life. I really hope you guys enjoyed this vlog. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, give it a like, because it really supports my channel and it gives me an idea of what kind of videos you guys like to see. Oh my gosh, I just had a really bad feeling that I was flashing you. Make sure to subscribe because I upload new videos every 3 days, and I'll see you in my next vlog, and I'll have a little bit more clothes on than this. Bye!